Hi, everybody. It is Wednesday, August 18th, about halfway through the month here, and here we go. It is overcast out today. I'm looking out the window. It's a little bit breezy, but it's overcast, so I think I might go out after we finish this up and do some work in the yard while it's while I'm not being baked in the sun. God, the reflection in here just drives me a little bit nuts. So I'm going to be reading some copious notes, so I'm going to take the glasses off at this point and get on with things. It was really great yesterday visiting Dolly Parton. It was just great reading everybody's comments in there. She's such a revered and incredible human being. And beyond her musicianship, she's just a remarkable human being. And I've always loved any chance I've had to work with Dolly and be around her. It's pretty amazing experience to get into that aura, that vibe close to her. And boy, you're a better person for it. But I thought, how do you follow Dolly? You know, what am I going to do today? And I just thought I'd visit another iconic individual. I've done a few projects with him. And this was an album that we did back in 1994. And that's Julio Iglesias. A unique artist. I remember the very first time I worked with him was at A&M Studios. And when we got booked for the date, they wouldn't tell us who the artist was. And I'm going, really? I mean, I got to put something in my book. You know, this is how I do my things. And they said, no, this we can't tell you. And I'm sitting there thinking, what is it, like Sinatra or somebody? You know, what's going on here? And we got to the studio and we were all set up in the big room. And all of a sudden this entourage blows in the room and there's Julio and the musicians. Nobody had ever heard of this guy. He hadn't done an American album before. I mean, he was, as we came to find out, well known because he was like one of the biggest selling artists in the world. But unfamiliar to an American audience, except probably the Latin audience. And we're all kind of sitting there going, well, you know, is this candid camera? Is it like Alan Funt hiding behind the window up there? Because we're looking at him going, who is this guy? I mean, for it to be top secret, you know, it was strange. But he turned out to be a great guy. We had a really great time in the studio, and it was really fun working with him. So I've had a couple opportunities to work with him over the years, and I even did Enrique Iglesias' first album. And so I've been involved with the family there. This album was his album Crazy from 1994. But I mean, Julio's one of the top selling artists in the world. I mean, as of like a number of years ago when they were accounting things, he had sold over 100 million albums. He apparently had done like over 5,000 concerts for as much as 60 million people during the course of his career up to that point. He's in the Latin Songwriters Hall of Fame. I mean, just a fascinating life when you actually start to look at his bio. You kind of go, Jesus, you know, the amount of awards and citations and all the things that he's amassed and his musical history. But I think if I was going to really get into that, we would be sitting here for another hour just going over that kind of stuff. So that's the kind of stuff you can go on Wikipedia or Google and get all that information if you're curious. But he is really a fascinating artist. We did this album, the bulk of all the tracking we did at the record plant here in Hollywood. Then they went on to do overdubs and things in different studios and with different people involved. But Albert Hammond produced this. Let's see if I have any info on that. Let's take a quick. Now, as Albert Hammond produced it, but there was a number of people. Bill Ross and David Campbell were doing arranging on this project. A bunch of different engineers. Umberto Gatica was one of the engineers on it. But the list of people involved is pretty extensive on this. But I just wanted to play a few songs from this because it was really an enjoyable project to do. And an unbelievably the top of the barrel players here in Los Angeles on it. So the first song I'm going to do is a song called Fragile. Fragile. And it's myself on bass, Mike Baird on drums. See, I've got my notes I've made here. Mike Baird on drums, Robbie Buchanan and C.J. Vanston on keyboards, Luis Conti and Mike Fisher on percussion. And then the backgrounds on this one were George Noriega, Hector Almaguer, I believe was his name, Jeannie Cruz, Rita Quintero, and Sting. And Sting is also the acoustic guitarist on this track. So here we go. This is Fragile. Fragile. boy, it just cruises along, just pretty just atmospheric, just beautiful. The next one I want to do is Mammy Blue, and then I'm going to tell you a little story from him. It's myself on bass, Mike Baird, again, on drums, Michael Thompson on electric guitar, and Albert Hammond on acoustic guitar, who produced this. Again, Robbie Buchanan on keys, and C.J. Vanston on synth, with Luis Conti and Mike Fisher on percussion in the background. Singers on this one are Alex Brown, Billy Trudell, Gene McLean, Larry Jacobs, Mark Free, and Terry Wood. So this is Mammy Blue and a Star.
Oh, baby.
Yeah, I mean, it's just its atmosphere. It's just these things just cruise along. So the story I was going to say, when we were in the studio, I was talking to Julio about, you know, just his life and what it's like. I got something in my eye here. What it's like, you know, just doing what he does, touring, you know, but the recognizability as his fame increased in this country. He told me a story about he had played a concert in Boston, and when he got back to the hotel, he was walking in the front door, and there was some guy just standing there, kind of just looked at him, and he was so pumped up from the show, he just went to the guy and he put his hand on his shoulder and he says, "What a great evening! Isn't this a great evening?" And went into the hotel. That was it. And he said about 20 minutes later, the police were knocking on his door and the guy was going to sue him for assault. You know, I mean, that's the kind of thing. He says you can't even touch somebody without somebody looking at him like he's bank and they're going to go ahead and sue him. So he says he doesn't want to seem rude, but he really tries to keep away from actually coming in contact with fans because things like this happen. He said all he did was just set his hand on the guy's shoulder and say, "What a good evening." And next thing you know, there's the cops and this guy's, he hit me, you know, and all this, and, you know, I'm going to sue you and all this. And Julio, I mean, he prevailed in it, but it just makes you gun shy of doing anything when you live in a world, this litigious world where everybody looks at somebody a little farther up the food chain as a free ride. It was really sad. So here's another song. Again, it's very, very similar cast of characters on this one. It's myself again and Mike Baird on drums and Michael Thompson on guitar and Robbie Buchanan on keyboards and Jesus Guzman on trumpet and Mike Fisher on percussion. And this is kind of a duet. It's Julio and Art Garfunkel singing this one. So here we go. It's called Let It Be Me. It's a great classic song. I've done this with other artists over the years, and it's a beautiful tune. So here we go.
You'll always let it
Classic old song. And it's fun hearing Artie. I've done a few albums with Artie. I'll get to those at some point on here too. It was always a kick being in the studio with him, having, you know, been such a fan of Simon and Garfunkel. It's always, you know, you turn into fanboy when you get around these artists who you enjoyed so much before you ever met them, and then you're suddenly in the studio with them working. And I think that one is still one of the craziest ones for me was when I first started working with Bill Medley of the Righteous Brothers, because I was such a huge Righteous Brothers fan back in the 60s. And when I actually went in the studio and there was Bill, and we call each other now, you know, and I pick up a phone and, is this Brother Lee? And this is Brother Bill here. You know, it's just like a trip, but a beautiful cat. I really totally dig him. So here's the last little thing here. And this is, I mean, a song of great renown. This is Crazy, written by Willie Nelson. And it's myself and Eddie Bayers on drums. And then Mike Baird was also involved on this one. But Michael Thompson on guitar and Robbie Buchanan and David Foster doing keyboards on this. Claude Gaudet is on this, Lester Mendez, and the sax on this is Dave Cause. So here we go. I mean, it's so weird when I do these things and I can kind of close my eyes and I can see just how we were all set up in the studio over at Record Plant. And it's just like time has really ceased to go on, because it just feels like yesterday on many levels. It's hard to believe how so much time has gone by. But here we go, Crazy.
Crazy, I'm crazy for feeling so lonely. I'm crazy. As long as you wanted, and then someday you'd leave me for somebody new. Worry, why do I let myself worry? In the world did I do? Crazy for thinking that my love could hold you. I'm crazy for trying, I'm crazy for crying, and I'm crazy. Thank you. love could hold. I'm crazy for trying and crazy for crying, and I'm crazy.
Such a great song, and so many wonderful interpretations of it out there over the years. And you just sit back and go, yeah, Willie. Willie is such an amazing artist, such a unique artist. So that's it. Just if you want to check out more songs on that, it's the album is Crazy, Julio Iglesias from 1994, and much further information is available on that, but really incredible sessions to do. And really, it was, you know, kind of back in the time when we would get to spend a week in the studio crafting an album instead of coming in and spending a day and trying to get a couple of tunes done without any end result. I'm looking forward to it. We're going to be going in the studio soon with Susanna Hoffs from the Bangles and doing a new album with her. And that's going to be kind of that way. We're going to be in for days tracking that, which is going to be a lot of fun. I'm really looking forward to that. And other than that, I'm going to go maybe do a little yard work now because it's still overcast. So maybe there's something going on with the weather here that I should take full advantage of. So I'm going to wish everybody a great day today. And I just remembered I have an interview this afternoon at 4:00. I better set my alarm so I don't work through that. But take good care. I'll tell you, just take a minute and just put your heart out there to all of these frontline workers that are working. The COVID numbers are still climbing like crazy. People are not getting shots and putting themselves in harm's way. And now they're talking about a third shot. And I tell you, I will be right, as soon as that's available, I will be in line for that. I had my 2 Moderna shots and I don't regret that for a second. And I will jump in for a third when the time comes that they're available, because I want to be alive at the end of this. And there's so many people who are dying. It's just crazy. And then to sit here and watch the news and see the nightmare that Afghanistan is, see the nightmare that Haiti is, just try to take advantage of the gift you're given every day by being alive here, and try to make the most of it and try to do good by the people around you, your friends, your family, your community. So take good care. I'm not sure where I'm going to be going tomorrow musically, but I'll be somewhere. I'll send you a postcard, let you know where I end up. But till then, just take good care. Have a wonderful day, and I will talk to you tomorrow. Okay, bye-bye.